checks off all the boxes technically, but there is no emotional connection, and it just, it felt bland. His memory. Metalheads, welcome to Graphic Metal, where metal is celebrated with design in mind. This is Metal in Review, the January 2024 edition. It's a review of all the albums that I listened to in the respected month, both good and not so good. FYI, we'll be presenting these based on when they were released, starting with the earliest. So with that, let's get to it. Prove Them Wrong by Jenner. It's a thrash metal album released on January 24th. It's really, really bad. Hey, I gave it a chance. It's just really bad. Graphic Metal rating of 58. Timeless by Dominia. It's a doom metal album released on January 26th. I didn't like it, but I did really like the album cover. It had a sick, you know, concept, represent time between a human and a skeleton, like hand holding up, you know, the sand of time. I thought it was really cool, but otherwise, didn't really like it. Graphic Metal rating of 66. His memory. Project Regeneration, Volume 2 by Static X. It's a new metal alternative industrial metal album released on January 26. Outside of the interesting cover take on Nine Inch Nails' Terrible Lie and the resemblance, kind of the band to trigger at least like memories in your head, there's not really anything that's worth your time here. I respect the effort and, you know, the desire to want to keep Wayne's memories alive. I really do like that. And you know, I think that they're doing a respectful job. But from an album, from a music standpoint, this isn't coming for me. Graphic Metal rating is a 51. Nonagon by Blood Red Thorn. A death metal album released on January 26. I can't do the vocals or the production, which didn't allow any of the instruments really to shine. This is one of those albums that checks off all the boxes technically, but there is no emotional connection. And it just, it felt bland. At least the album cover was solid. But nonetheless, Graphic Metal rating gives it a 61. Burnout Codes by Heave Blood and Die. What a band name. And at this point, you guessed it. It's released in January 26. This one is a stoner rock, alt metal, psychedelic punk. It's a fusion band. It's all over the place. I found myself really enjoying a number of the songs. It was a little uneven, but overall, a lot of inspiration and interesting fusion of songs here, sounds here. It was decent. I also really loved the album cover. It was cleverly brought to life, great layout and typography, and just overall interesting. Kept my eye. If I was seeing on the shelf, I definitely would have picked it up and that's half the battle, right? So kudos to them. It's decent. Graphic Metal score is 77. And I'm going to call this one the Diamond in the Rough album of 2024. Phoenix by The Gems, a hard rock album released on January 26. Listening to this makes you question if they're in it for the right reason. I'm saying it honestly. Throughout the entire album, something just constantly always felt like it was something was missing. It felt like there was no soul. It felt robotic. It felt like it was AI generated, not fully fleshed humans actually with passion playing something that they really enjoyed. I felt like the members had no chemistry, the songs lack character, and it just, I don't know. As a result, it didn't come off as very effective. It lacked heart, it lacked anything memorable. The weird thing is that I was coming in kind of actually excited. I thought that they showed early signs of talent when I, you know, dabbled in hearing a few songs before the album came out. This was maybe last year, I think. But yeah, this just did not work. It just comes off as just bland. Definitely not a gem. Graphic Metal rating is unfortunately a 55. Magna Mater by Kalt Vindur, a black metal album released on January 26. I'm just going to save you trouble. It was terrible. I didn't really like anything of it, pretty much. Graphic Metal rating was a 59. Lucifer V by Lucifer, a hard rock album released on January 26. Once upon a time, this was a band that I actually was interested in and kept my eye on. But at this point, kind of feels irrelevant. They almost feel like, despite the fact that they haven't been around for very long, it sounds tired and uninspiring as if they've already checked out. It's weird. Graphic Metal rating is 64. Charcoal Grace by Caligula's Horse, a prog metal album released on January 26. A lot of January 26 releases. I guess everybody wanted to, you know, get their album in January for some reason. I love this band, or I have loved this band up until this point. Unfortunately, I couldn't get into this one. Usually a stellar album, a band. It kind of very similar to a Tesseract. Also, another band that I'm not a big fan of, quite frankly. Is what it is. But this band, however, I've liked all the elements. I like their chemistry. I like the vocals. I like just their what they bring. That's a little bit fresh and different into the prog, more accessible kind of side of things. But unfortunately, this one just had minimal moments that kept me interested. It's a bummer, but it's still solid. I do recommend it. If it were me, I would recommend going to their other albums, I guess is what I'm saying. Graphic Metal score is a 73. Legend Legend by Exocrine. I think I'm saying that right. Exocrine. A technical death metal album released on January 26th. There are some interesting moments, but overall, this was pretty boring. Graphic Metal rating is a 63. Mycelium by Manticora, a melodic death metal album released on January 26th. God awful, just skip it. Graphic Metal rating of 54. Suffer and Become by Vitriol. A death metal album released on January 26th. Whew. Exhausting. Made me feel like I just finished like an Ironman and want to go back to sleep. But it really is, but it's solid. I don't want you to get the wrong impression. It's a solid death metal album. Also a solid album cover as well. Graphic Metal rating is a 67. Phantazein by Cognizance, a death metal album released on January 26th. Could be the worst album of the month. Graphic Metal rating is a 41. I do not recommend it at all. Old Eyes, New Heart by Mater Mortem, a prog rock album, again released on January 26th. This is yet another big, big disappointment. This is a band I fell in love with. I mean, not that long ago. I'd have to re-look up. I'm curious, what was the album that of theirs? Marl was an album of the year candidate for me. I really thoroughly enjoyed that one, but this is like an entirely different band at this point. I really found myself kind of puzzled as to, I didn't re-listen to like that album or their albums before, but I remember always thoroughly being appreciative of their innovation. They always had something fresh and interesting, but this just wasn't hitting the notes for me. I really couldn't. It felt unrecognizable and uneven. It just was a really, really a big shame for me. I was a little bit disappointed, but I still recommend this band, or at least definitely their catalog. Graphic Metal score of this one is a 68. Veneration of Medieval Mysticism and Cosmolo by Inquisition. It's a black metal album released on January 26th. This is going to be the surprise review/rating because this is one of those bands that is beloved. They have a huge cult following, including actually myself in the past. Bloodshed Across the Emporium Altar Beyond the Celestial Zenith was one of my favorite black metal albums it was 2016. This one, however, just, it wasn't that great for me. It's yet another. There's been a lot of already disappointments coming in January in this month, but this was yet another one. It was rough. It used to be that the old mixing was their asset. This felt like a detriment. It felt like the vocals weren't even really like singing, and it felt more like spoken word. I know it's harsh, but just giving my honest opinion, I've been a fan of this band in the past, and even the production. I felt like it used to be an asset, and now not so much. I don't know if it's just time, bad timing or whatnot. I'll give it another listen to, but unfortunately, I thought it was just, it felt more average, I guess is what I'm saying. Whereas before, they really felt like they were elevated, a little bit different and worthy of a higher rating. But in this case, the Graphic Metal rating is just a 62. And that was a list. That was what I heard, the things I liked and things I didn't like from the month of January 2024 on to February next. Excited about that and excited to release the work on the designs and release tasks. This way you can enjoy and support the bands. Please support the bands. Support channel if you want to. But yeah, hope you have a good one. Keep on rocking. Cheers.